you know, that was really interesting to me anyway. I mean, like, first of all, you know, that I know you've heard a lot of that. If you're listening to the show, you've heard a lot of these things that I complain about the administrative state, and it is just immensely important. And we, you know, we concentrate the press, the media, it creates this cloud. I mean, this is the thing that the right doesn't understand about the culture. The culture works by immersion. It doesn't work by, oh, you know, there's an idea and now everybody's going to follow that idea. It works by constantly hearing that this is what's hip, this is what's cool, this is what Stephen Colbert laughs at, this is what George Clooney gives to, this is what all these people who you may disdain but who create the culture around you are saying, and that is what really affects people. But the truth does have a constituency. I mean, this is, you know, one of my favorite articles, let me see if I, yeah, here it is, one of my favorite articles recently comes from Variety. Variety, for those of you who don't know, is our trade, showbiz trade thing. You know, if you're in the movies, if you're in theater, you want to read Variety and find out what's going on. They reported on a panel at a conference in Beverly Hills called "Has Politics Made Late Night Great Again?" And it was all these comedy writers from, you know, the Samantha Bee Show and the Daily Show with Trevor Noah and all of these guys. And they're very disgruntled. I mean, I love this article. It says panelists included Ashley Nicole Black, a writer for Full Frontal with Samantha Bee, Christine Nangle. "I just find it exhausting. It's hard to find it fun," said Jason Reich, the head writer for the Jim Jefferies Show. It can really get boring to deal with this same person, Trump, provoking the same level of outrage with everything he does," said Hagelin from The Daily Show with Trevor Noah. "All of them are complaining that they're not getting through. They say we're not getting through to the other side. They all admit that they're on the other side. One of them says, I wonder how much is preaching to the choir. We're not really going to convert anyone, but we're trying to point things out that people might have missed." So they admit that they're all on one side. They've never met us. They don't know what we think. They really don't know what we believe. See, we know what they believe because we see them on TV, because they manufacture our entertainment, because they manufacture our mainstream news. We know what they think. They have no clue who you are. They have no clue who you are. I get this all the time. You know, in my neighborhood, in the people I meet, they think I must be a monster. I kind of support Donald Trump. I'm a conservative. I must be a bad guy. They do not know. And that is kept in place by Stephen Colbert, who every day uses the public airways to insult every single person between New York and LA. It doesn't matter because he can get his audience from all the rest. He can get a big audience from all the rest. So he doesn't care that he's spitting on all those people. And I think that the thing is that culture, that is the thing that we have to be thinking about all the time. How do we get our voices out there? Podcasts are great. YouTube is great. But all these places, they try to censor right-wing voices because they do not know who we are. They just assume if we disagree with them, it must be hateful. And that really is what we have to work on, what we have to think about. We don't just have to think about ideas and governance and all this stuff. We have to think about the culture and how we communicate and who we are and how we appear and making sure that people know who we are.